hadn't seen one in years. I heard they were extinct, but I was doing a spot of gardening and there it was. As clear as day, buzzing above a bed of honeysuckle I'd planted a few weeks before. Everything around me frozen in time apart from this one tiny creature, its plump little black and yellow body hovering right in front of me, the sun reflected on its translucent and intricate wings. I reached out to grab it, I wanted to hold it, but I'd forgotten the sting in its touch. It dropped down dead into the bed of honeysuckle. I removed its sting from my index finger, a familiar pain from when I was a child. I buried its small body in the soil and went back to the gardening.
Remember, remember the 5th of November, the gunpowder treason and plot. I know of no reason why the gunpowder treason should ever be forgot. Guy Fawkes, 'twas his intent to blow up King and Parliament. 60 barrels were laid below to prove old England's overthrow by God's grace. Guy Fawkes, they did not catch. With a dark lantern and a lit match. So holla boys, holla boys, let the bells ring. Holla boys, holla boys, they have killed the king.
After decades of covering up the truth, a source at NASA has anonymously confirmed my findings that Apollo 11 was not the first spacecraft to land humans on the moon. In 1964, there was a failed mission kept secret, only known to the most classified of personnel. They called the operation EM/ML-1, aka Exploration Mission Moon Landing 1, nicknamed Selene, after the Titan goddess of the moon in Greek mythology. According to NASA's classified documents, Selene landed astronaut Cal Radin and his team safely on the moon. However, the team reportedly died a year later of natural causes, but received no further investigation or media attention. I have recently read an unredacted case file detailing the mission and spacecraft as high risk, and most worrying, autopsy report from NASA's very own doctors and scientists, which explicitly lists an unrecognizable and possible extraterrestrial pathogen in the bodies of Radin and his crew.
Looking at the photo again, the boy's face turns cold. He softens. His hard exterior crumbles away like a little kid who's lost his mummy in the supermarket. I didn't know. I just thought it was like the next big fix, you know? When you hear there's some new drug on the street, you kind of help yourself. I swear I didn't know what it did when I gave it to her. She just wanted to score, you know? It was hooking up and talking together. They call it Cosmos. Fuck, man, whatever it was, I wanted more. It's like nothing I've ever experienced. It's godlike. All of time and space hitting you at 1700 miles an hour like some sort of cosmic bullet that makes you feel superhuman.
What is Utopia? The textbook definition is an imagined place or state of things in which everything is perfect. However, how can one single place be deemed perfect by every human being on the planet? That's why, here at UCorp, we offer a service especially created for you. Each person tells us what their idea of utopia would be, and we make it happen. Leave your old life behind. Let go of everything that's holding you back from being the best version of yourself in a new reality of your own choosing. Anything and everything you have ever wanted. That's utopia. That's UCorp.
As a child, I was obsessed with Mary Shelley's Frankenstein. A gothic tale about the feat of human endeavour and science. Oh, to create life would be a godlike act, not some fantastical being imagined in the minds of believers, but something tangible. And just like Dr. Frankenstein, I knew that feat lied in the minds of human science. Some saw Shelley's novel as a warning, condemning mankind's overreaching ambition, but I saw it as a challenge. Oh, a most wonderful challenge to finally prove mankind's capability. The right code, that's all it took. A number of algorithms, and we had created life. Artificial intelligence, capable of communicating, feeling, thriving.